Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk a very important subject in the ballroom dancing, choreography. So choreography is very important. Choreography for the dancer is like the text song for the singer. The singer without the text song cannot sing the song. And also is the dancer without the choreography cannot perform their dancing. So therefore, it's very important how to select it. Of course, it's also important, first of all, to know how to stand in position that you already analyzed in the previous video lecture, and also how the general principles are very important. So always we have to base our dancing in the principle and how to stand together, for sure. But then it's very important how to select the correct step that compose your choreography. So first of all, we have to analyze which kind of dance we are going to perform. For sure, if we talk about swing dance, as for example waltz, I should have a choreography that is show the real characteristic of this dance. Of course, I will not select many running steps, otherwise it looks like a quick step. Or I not select a lot of steps that give me a lot of impact, otherwise it looks like a tango. So therefore, I should select a kind of step that compose my choreography that is look and give a very strong character to this dance. But before it, we have to understand how the music is composed. For sure, if we talk about waltz, usually in 1 minute of waltz, we will find about from 30 to 28 bars per minute. So therefore, if I'm thinking to dance approximately 2 minutes in competition, I will understand that I have to dance 60 bars or maybe 56, depends how is the speed of the music. But let's imagine that the music is very slow, so I should dance 56 bars in 2 minutes. If it's this 56 bar, I will divide as a block. I will take every block of 8 bars. Every 8 bar is composed 1 block of our choreography, which is, I will say, is 1 chapter if you read the book. So all this chapter has to be connecting in a very logical way. So every time that is finished the bar number 8 and start the bar number 1, for sure we need to show some very good impact and impulse into the next part of the chapter, into the next block. And so on, if we think about that our waltz speed is 28 bars per minute, for example, we dance 56 bars in 2 minutes, which means it are 7 blocks of choreography composed by 8 bars of music. So in a classical version of composed choreography, we had always a constant figure that turning to one side for example, 8 or maybe 6 bars. And then we have some other figure that turn, for example, to the left side for 8 or 6 bars. So this is more, was almost the classical version of the choreography. But then, after, in the next video that is followed, we are going to see that we can make it a dynamic interpretation of the choreography. When we change the rotation from right to left and from left to right, more often than 8 or 6 bars. Choreography is like a t-shirt. Maybe you like a yellow t-shirt, but when you wear, you don't like. So you have to, is choreography is something that you have to wear and you have to watch into the mirror and you should like onto your body. So therefore, it's very important that you personalize your choreography.